Good morning, friends. Welcome back to the class. I hope you all are safe and healthy too. Today in this session, we are going to learn the concept of tangent and normal to the given curve. Before we start the concept, you must know you have studied about the straight line concept in 11th standard. And the complete concept of straight line which we are going to use in this concept. So that's why we need to recall those fundamentals which we required in this topic. So within a couple of minutes, first we'll recall those formulas. I will list out over here, and please note down these formulas and this concept before you start the concept of tangent and normals. As you know, what is meant by slope, right? According to the straight line concept, it is just given by the formula m is equal to tan theta, where theta is basically the angle made by the straight line in a positive direction. Let us say this is a straight line L, and the angle made by the straight line is theta, then slope of this line is given by tan of this angle, which we called as what? Slope, right? Slope can also be determined, right, when you know the two points on it. Let us say there are two points whose coordinates are x1 comma y1. Next point is x2 comma y2. Then the slope of this line, also given by the difference of y coordinates, that is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So there are basically two ways to find the slope of a given line. Either you know the angle made by the line with the x-axis in positive direction, or else you can say, if a line is passing through two known points, right? So with the help of this slope concept, we also studied that if the two lines are parallel, this is the first point to be noted. Second is, if lines are parallel, it implies that their slopes are equal, even vice versa. If the two lines are parallel, ultimately their slopes are equal. And third point, if lines are perpendicular, you could say their product of their slopes, m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. So these are the concepts which you have studied under the slope head, right? Apart from the slope head, you also studied the equation of a straight line, right? So, equation of a straight line which is passing through a given point. Equation of a straight line which is passing through given point. x1, y1, and you know the slope of the line m, right? Joined by m. So, line consisting of infinitely many points. So, I can take any random point on it. Now, by using the two-point form, I could write the slope concept, that the slope of this line is given by y minus y1 upon x minus x1. This will lead the equation of the straight line. By formula we are speaking like y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So this will give the equation of the straight line passing through one single point, x1, y1, and having the slope m. So when you know the two things about the line, one is the slope, second is the point, then you can use this slope formula, that is y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. You could frame the equation of the straight line. So minimum knowledge you require to start the topic is this. So, if you are aware about these four points before you start the topic, it is easy for you to understand the concept of tangent and normal, which is one of the application of derivatives which is introduced in 6.3 in our syllabus. Okay, so what is tangent, what is normal? First we need to understand and then we'll go for their equations, right? So let us say there is a curve, a random curve I'm taking, denoted by f of x, and there is a point P. Let us say the point is some h comma k, because I am assuming it's a real point whose coordinates are known to us. Then at this point, if I draw a line to the curve, which is continuous curve, right, then the line which is intersecting the curve at one single point is called a tangent. This you know very well since, I think, since last 3 years when you are studying in 10th standard, you know the tangent means what? A line which is touches a curve, which does the circle at a given point, is known as a tangent. Similarly, here the tangent means a line which touch the given curve or intersect the curve at a given point. At a given point is called a tangent. Similarly, now if I draw a line which is exactly perpendicular to the tangent, through the same point, is called normal. So basically, the tangent and the normal are the two straight lines which are perpendicular to each other at a common point to the curve. So hence, here the tangent and the normal are perpendicular to each other. So hence, the slope of tangent, into the slope of normal, is equal to -1, as straight line concept speaks over here. If the two lines are perpendicular, then the product of their slopes is equal to -1. Hence, I could say the slope of tangent into slope of normal is always gives -1. When you know the slope of tangent, you will be able to find the slope of the normal by using the concept. M1 into M2 is equal to -1. This is one of the learning points. The one is they are perpendicular, hence their product of their slopes is equal to -1. The second point is, here, most important point, right? Remember, this h comma k is a point where the tangent and the normal are constructed to the given curve, right, satisfying all the three graphs. It means that this h comma k lies on the f of x, lies on the tangent, lies on the normal. Hence, we could say this h comma k point satisfying f of x, tangent, and normal, means you can substitute this h comma k point in the curve as well as in the tangent equation as well as in the normal equation. Now the third point from this graph, if I want to find equation of tangent, how could I proceed? Simply, tangent is a straight line. To find the equation of straight line, what we require, only two things. One is the slope of the line. Second, I should know the point, one real point on the line. So what is a real point where the tangent is constructed? So h comma k is treated as x1 comma y1, and the slope of tangent, how could you find the slope of tangent here? Simply by finding the derivative of the graph, are derivative of even function, are derivative of even curve at this point. So if you are finding the slope of the graph at this h comma k, you are basically finding the slope of the tangent. So hence you could say, first the slope can be determined by derivative of the function at h comma k. Once you find the slope by using the derivative, now you can write the equation of the tangent is y minus y1 is equal to, I'm simply writing f dash x into x minus x1. So this is what equation of tangent. Instead of writing m, I usually write f dash x to remember myself that here the slope is obtained by the derivative of the function. Hence, this is we called as application of derivative, right? So in the concept of tangent and normal. Now coming to the next and the last equation of normal. How could I find the equation of normal? Simply, I know the slope of tangent into slope of normal is equal to minus 1. If the slope of tangent is f dash x, then slope of normal is minus 1 by f dash x. And second point will be same at which the tangent and normals are passing through or intersect each other in a given curve. Hence, this point will be same when you are making the equation of tangent or when you are forming the equation of normal. For both the lines, the point x1 comma y1 will be remain same. Only slopes are different. Hence, the equation of normal is given by y minus y1 is equal to minus 1 upon the derivative of the function into x minus x1 over. So, very simple to remember these formulas. Only if you are able to understand the previous knowledge of 11th standard of straight line concept. Slope of the any straight line is given by the formula, that is fundamental formula is tan theta. But it is only possible to use where you know the theta, that is angle made by the line with the x-axis in positive direction. Then you can use this formula to find the slope. What is the other way to find the slope? When you know the two real points on it, right, x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2, then you can use this formula to find the slope. Similarly, parallel condition, perpendicular condition, and then equation of the straight line. So if you are able to remember these four points, with the help of these four points, you can derive these four points, and with the help of these four points, you can start the exercise and you can just go with the exercise thoroughly without any hesitation. Fine. So these are the four points you need to remember in our concept. One, always try to make a rough figure for each question when you start. Always draw a simple curve f of x in same form, and if you are dealing with tangent, only construct the tangent. If you are dealing with normal, then construct the normal. Always make a symbol they are perpendicular. Always write the point of intersection or point at which you are dealing with, that as h comma k or x1 comma y1, nothing else. So once you draw the figure, then you will be directly getting a clear idea about the question, how to proceed it. Only you have four options. Either they will ask for you to find the slope, or they will be asked for you to find the equation of normal, or they will ask the equation of tangent, or they will ask the point of intersection. Point of intersection. Whenever they are asking about what is the point of intersection of the graph and the tangent. Remember, this point is satisfying the curve, tangent and normal, all the three curves. Means you can substitute this point in all the three equations wherever it is required. Now, with the help of this fundamental knowledge, now we are going to move to discuss few important questions randomly from the exercise 6.3 from NCERT textbook itself. Okay, let's have a discussion on that. Yeah. So we are dealing with the exercise 6.3 from NCERT textbook. I'm taking the question number 1 as a beginner. I'm writing the question 2. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve. Find the slope of the tangent to the curve y is equal to 3x to the power of 4 minus 4x at x is equal to. See how simple it is. What they are asking, simply they are asking only slope of the tangent, okay, and to this curve at x is equal to 4. So to find the slope of tangent, what we do, just we go with the derivative of the graph. So what is the function curve given to us? That is what the given curve, and we'll go with the derivative, and in the derivative we'll substitute x is equal to 4 to find the slope. That's it. So what is the given curve first? Y is equal to 3x to the power of 4 minus 4x. It implies derivative of the graph. It becomes what? 12x cubed minus 4. Hence, now what do you want to find? Slope, that is m. You can also speak like slope of tangent is nothing but derivative of the function at whatever the point is given, x is equal to 4. So derivative of the function mein aap derivative mein kya put karoge, at x is equal to 4 bola hai, so 4 ki value substitute karo. That's it. So 4 cube means 64 minus 4. So whatever the value are getting, that will be the slope, 4. Okay, so this is what simply finding the slope of the tangent to the curve. Simply do the derivative and substitute the given point, that will give the slope. In short, over. So now move to the next question. Question number 5 we are now discussing. Question number 5. Question number 5 is, find the slope of normal to the curve x is equal to a into cos cube theta comma y is equal to a sine cube theta at theta is equal to pi by 4. Just tell me, if you observe the curve, which is basically a parametric form, x and y, both the variables are expressible in terms of theta, and this form of the equation is known as parametric form of the equation. And hence, to find the derivative of this parametric, you have done a lot of practice on it. With the respective theta, we'll do the derivative first and we'll get the dy by dx that we'll consider as a slope of the curve, and we can also say slope of the tangent to the curve. Now simply first we'll go with the derivative. Without derivative, none of the question will start. Okay, first I'm taking the curve, equation of the curve. What is the curve given to us? Right, x is equal to a cos cube theta and y is equal to a sin cube theta. Now first do the derivative with respect to theta. Right, we are writing differentiate with respect to theta, because x and y both are in terms of theta is given. Now it means that dx by d theta will be given as a is a constant, keep it outside. If this is the form of x cubed, then first its derivative will be 3 cos square theta into derivative of cos theta, simply by chain rule. Then dx by d theta is given by, finally, you can also multiply here, 3a cos square theta into derivative of cos theta is minus sine theta. So this is what you could say the derivative of the first part. And in the similar manner, first we are going to find dy by d theta. So dy by d theta would be a into 3 sine square theta and the derivative of sine theta in the product by chain rule. Now derivative of sine theta is cos theta. So final answer would be 3 into a sine square theta into cos theta. Now I required dy by dx, and you know how to find dy by dx, simply by dividing dy by d theta by dx by d theta. So dy by d theta is 3a sine square theta into cos theta upon minus 3a cos square theta into sine theta. Now where the factors 3a get cancelled. 1 sine and sine get cancelled, 1 cos and 1 cos get cancelled. We are left with minus sine theta by cos theta, which is reduced to minus tan theta. This is the derivative of the given curve, which will also treated as slope of tangent. This is derivative. Now, what we are going to find? Slope of normal. So before we find the slope of normal, first we'll find slope of tangent, and with the help of slope of tangent, we'll go with the slope of normal. So slope of tangent, I'm talking about M of tangent, MT. Shortly I'm writing MT means slope of tangent is simply the derivative of the function, derivative of the curve at a given point. What is the point given at? Pi by 4. So slope of tangent is equal to minus tan theta at theta is equal to pi by 4. So slope of tangent is minus tan. Then substitute the value of theta over here. Tan pi by 4 is 1. And slope of tangent is becomes minus 1. But as you know that slope of tangent into slope of normal is always equal to minus 1. So to get the slope of normal, just substitute slope of tangent over here. That is minus 1 into slope of normal is equal to minus 1. Get cancelled. So slope of normal is what? Slope of normal is equal to 1. This is your final answer. Just try to understand. In this question, only the derivative part is lengthy. Reason is the curve is given in parametric form. So this curve may be of any form. If you have done the enough practice in the derivative chapter, that is previous one, you will be able to find the derivative of the given function in a general way by using the chain rule and parametric form and x, y, z forms, right? So once you know the derivative of the function, then simply go for the tangent, slope of tangent, that is simply the derivative of the function at a given point. So the point will be very clearly given to you in the question itself. Substitute that point in the derivative simply to get the slope of tangent. And you know the slope of tangent into slope of normal is always equal to minus 1. Then slope of normal will be just reciprocal of tangent. So this is the fundamental concept everybody should know. Then only you can move for the next level of the questions. Correct? Now next part. Now the next question I am checking here, question number 14, question number 14, first part. What are they are asking? They are asking about find the equation of tangent and normal, both normal, to the given curve, at given point. Right? Find the equation of the tangent and normal to the given curve at a given point. And what is a curve and what is a point given to us? Y is equal to x to the power of 4 minus 6x cubed plus 13x squared minus 10x plus 5 at 0, 5. So first we'll go with the rough figure, because now we are moving to the equation of tangent and normals. We always require a rough figure to understand the concept. So try to draw the graph whenever it is required. So simply take always a graph like this, like a crescent, and name this as the function. Whatever the function given to you, that is called f of x r y. Now take a random point on it where the point is given at 0, 5. So this is the point where you are going to find the equation of tangent to the curve. So this is what tangent, and construct, because we are dealing with normal also in this question, tangent and normal both. So construct the perpendicular to this line, consider as normal, and which is exactly perpendicular to the tangent. So this is a rough figure. Now we are going to move to the question. To find the equation of tangent and normal, first we require their slopes. So first, to get the slope of the normal and tangent, we require the derivative of the function. Derivative say slope, slope say equation. You always remember this one. This is the first step. Take the curve y dash, that is a derivative. Through derivative, you can find the slope of tangent. Through the slope of tangent, you can go with the slope of what we call slope of normal. And with the slope of tangent, you can find the equation of tangent. With the slope of normal, you can find the equation of normal. So this is what the simple figure to understand the entire concept. इसी के पीछे हम दौड़ते हैं, क्लियर? चलिए, सो फर्स्ट वी रिक्वायर, व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट लेवल डेरिवेटिव, सो फर्स्ट वी गो विद दैट, सो y डैश विल बी गिवन डायरेक्टली, हियर आई एम राइटिंग डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस फंक्शन, 18x स्क्वायर प्लस 26x माइनस 10. नाउ व्हाट डू यू वांट टू फाइंड? स्लोप ऑफ टेंजेंट. सो स्लोप ऑफ टेंजेंट मींस सिंपली द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द फंक्शन at given point. What is the given point? 0 comma at 0 comma 5. So simply write first derivative. What is the derivative we have? 4x cube minus 18x square plus 26x minus 10 at 0 comma 5. So slope of tangent means in the entire expression, we need to substitute the value of x. And what is the value of x from here? This is x and this is y. So value of x only required. X is 0. Then substitute 0 in the equation. You will left with only minus 10. Once you know the slope of the tangent, you can find slope of normal just by reciprocating it. Minus 1 upon slope of tangent. Okay. So slope of normal is simply minus 1 by minus 10. Minus minus get cancelled. So slope of normal is 1 by 10. So now you know the slope of tangent, slope of normal. Now with the help of this slope of tangent and the slope of normal, you can go for equation of tangent and equation of normal. Now, what is the equation of tangent? Now, with the help of this, I am writing equation of tangent. And what is the equation of tangent? You know how to write first formula type. Y minus y1 is equal to the derivative of the function into x minus x1. And you know what is x1, y1 here? This is x1 and this is y1. Always at which the tangent and normal are constructed. And you know the slope of tangent is minus 10. That is what derivative also you can speak. Fine. So now I am just simply substituting that. Y minus, y1 is 5. Slope of the tangent is minus 10. Into x minus x1 is 0. So y minus 5 is equal to minus 10x, or simply you can write it as in the standard form, 10x plus y minus 5 equal to 0. This is the equation of tangent. Done. Now in a similar manner, which we are going to find what equation of normal. And you know, to find the equation of normal, simply the point of intersection will remain same, only the slopes are different. So same formula, again y minus y1 equal to minus 1 upon what we called as slope of the derivative, minus 1 upon derivative, or else you already know the slope of tan, normal, you can substitute that. What is the slope of normal? We got as 1 by 10 into x minus x1. And what is y1 here? what is y1? 5. And what is x1? 0. See, x1, y1 remain same. Only in place of slope minus 10, I substitute 1 by 10 to get the equation of normal. Now, do the simple one. Do the cross multiplication. 10y minus 50 equal to x. Or also you can speak x minus 10y plus 50 equal to 0. This is the equation of normal. I think it's so simple and straightforward to understand the concept. This is a flow where the function will be given to you. You will find the derivative. Once you do the derivative, substitute the point at which the tangent and normals are formed, right, in that derivative answer. So you will get the derivative. That is called what? Slope of tangent. Once you know the slope of tangent, you can go with the equation of tangent by this way. Then slope of normal is simply minus 1 upon slope of tangent. Once you know the slope of normal, then go with the equation of normal. This is the fundamental, very fundamental thing which everybody is required to understand and everybody can do. Even an average child is also can do this type of questions and you must do even. Chaliye. Then we'll go with the next concept where apart from the regular slope equation, we'll move on to the next part where they may connect the things with the other equation of lines and other equation of curves. Let's have a discussion on that. And then question number 15, very very interesting and learning question also. 15 question. Find the equation of tangent to the line. What they are asking only, find the equation of the tangent. Find the equation of the tangent line to the curve, and what is that curve given? Y is equal to x square minus 2x plus 7, which is first one parallel to the line 2x minus y plus 9 equal to 0. Second, perpendicular to the line 5y minus 15x is equal to. It's a beautiful question, frequently asked in boards. See, for 4 marks even. You can just read the question properly. Find the equation of the tangent. Only we are dealing with tangent. No need to construct the normal. So, find the equation of tangent to the curve which is parallel to a general line. In the second case, which is perpendicular to the general line. So, how the figure looks like? So, this is the curve f of x whose equation is this. And take a point on it first, which is unknown to us. We don't know at which point the tangent is constructed in this question. And this is the norm. This is what? A tangent to the curve. But this tangent is, in the case 1, parallel to this line. It means that in case 1, the lines, it is a basically an equation of line. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So, tangent is parallel to this line in case 1, whose equation is 2x minus y plus 9 equal to 0. I can assume this line 1. And this tangent is also perpendicular to the other line L2, right, whose equation is given to us. What is the equation? 5y minus 15x is equal to 30. So this is basically the information given to us. See, we are going to find the equation of tangent to the curve, right, where tangent to the line which is parallel to this line, as well the equation of tangent is perpendicular to this line. Okay, so now how could we find the equation of tangent and the in the both the cases, case 1 and case 2. It is case 2. First we'll solve the case 1 and then we'll go with the case 2. Okay, case by case. Now, first, simply without any hesitation, we'll take the curve and we'll do the derivative in usual form, right? So, I'm just solving the first part. Before we start the first part, we can go with the derivative also, which will be useful in both the ones, right? So, derivative, first, y is equal to what is given, x square minus 2x plus 7. Hence, the derivative of this function is what? 2x minus 2. This is result number 1. But, in the what is this basically the derivative gives? The slope of the tangent. So, you may also write therefore, m, that is slope of tangent, is given by 2x minus 2. You can assume this as result number 1. So, we got the slope of tangent, but here the tangent is parallel to L1, hence the slope of this tangent and the slope of this line must be equal. Because these two lines are parallel, then their slopes must be equal. So, here you can say slope of tangent, or you can also speak like tangent is parallel to line 1, which is given. So therefore, slope of tangent must be equal to slope of L1. And what is the slope of tangent we obtained? That is 2x minus 2. And what is the slope of L1? You know how to find the slope of any line in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Remember, this is most important point to remember, that it is called the general form of the straight line, where ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. A is the coefficient of x and b is the coefficient of y, c is the constant. From here, you can find the slope m, that is slope of this line, by using the formula minus a by b. So, simply now, what is the slope of line 1? Iska slope kya hoga? Slope of this line 1, minus a by b formula se hum find karte hain. A is 2, B is minus 1. Substitute here, you will get minus 2 upon minus 1, that is 2. Okay, so slope of line 1 is 2. Getting my point? So from here, you will be able to get 2x is equal to 4, x is equal to 2 by the given condition. So basically, we got by equating them, we got the x coordinate of the point. Still, we don't know the y coordinate of this point. So from the given condition, what we are going to do, actually what we are doing, we are just using the information to find the coordinates of this point. Until and unless you know this point, you cannot determine the equation of tangent. Remember, until and unless you know the coordinates of the point of intersection, you cannot determine the equation of tangent. And that is what our question is. See, we are going to find the equation of tangent. So to find the equation of tangent, you require two things. One is a slope, second is a point. Slope is simply by obtaining the derivative of the function at a given point. And point is also required for that. So, but we don't have the point of intersection in the given question anywhere. This is called indirect question, where some information is given to you to find the point of intersection. And what the information provided? That the given tangent is parallel to the general line that figure shows. So with the help of straight line concept, we will be able to find the value of x as 2, and the coordinate of this point will be what? Now 2 comma y. Now the question is, how to find this y? As you know very well, this point of intersection lies on the curve as well as on the tangent. Hence, this point is satisfying both given curve as well as given tangent. We don't have tangent, then what is left? What we are left with? This point is satisfying the equation of curve. Hence, we will substitute this point in the equation of curve to get the value of y. This is the concept. So first, we are going with that only. Now, here the point 2 comma y lies on the function or the curve, you can say lies on given curve. Therefore, y is equal to, I'm substituting here, in place of x, what we have? 2. So y would be given by 2 square minus 2 into 2 plus 7. Therefore, y would be 4 minus 4 is 0. 7. Therefore, the required point will be 2 comma 7. Now, we got the sufficient information to move to the equation of tangent. Now, you know the real point at which the tangent is constructed, that is 2 comma 7. And then, you must know the slope of the tangent for that. What is the slope of tangent? We have, that is from equation 1, you can speak here. If you substitute x is equal to 2 over here, you will be able to get the real value of slope of tangent. So slope of tangent will be 2 times of x is equal to 2 minus 2, that is equal to 4 minus 2, that is 2. So now you know the real point at which the tangent is constructed. Now you know the slope of real tangent as a real value. Now you can go with the last step, that is equation of tangent. So equation of tangent is given by y minus y1 is equal to n into x minus x1. So y minus 7 is equal to 2 times of x minus 2. Hence y minus 7 equal to 2x minus 4. Then simply shift all the terms in a proper way. 2x minus y, right, is equal to minus 3, or you can also speak plus 3 equal to 0. So this is your final answer. Part 1 is over. First part is over. We were using the concept of parallel lines, means concept of this first part. So what we have done, simply, what is our target? Our target is to find the point of intersection. We must know the value of x and y. To find one of the coordinate, we are having the information that the tangent is not parallel to the given line. Hence, their slopes must be equal. And the slope of tangent is given by the derivative of the function. Simply, I found the derivative of the function, that is 2x minus slope of tangent. And slope of the line is obtained by the formula minus a by b, because this equation is given in general format of the line ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Hence, now I know the slope of tangent and slope of line. Since they are parallel, I equated both the slopes to get the value of x. Then I substitute the x is equal to over here to get the real value of the tangent, that is what slope of tangent is 2. Now I know the x value as 2 and I don't know the value of y, hence I could write 2 comma y is the point where with satisfying the equation of the curve, hence I can substitute the value of x in the curve to get y. So I know now the real point of the real coordinates of the point. Now I know the coordinates of point P, slope, then I can find the equation of tangent. So this is the simple concept. Now we are going with part 2, where the same curve, same tangent, right, is perpendicular to this line. Is perpendicular to this line by using the perpendicular condition. Instead of parallel, we are using the perpendicular condition. The second half will be remain same. Method wise. So I am just erasing this. I'm also erasing the first one, which is done. Now, what is the line, equation of line, which is perpendicular to this line? So, you may also see the equation of the line from the figure itself, already written. So, we are dealing with part B. So, already derivative we have done. What is y dash? Y dash is 2x minus 2. You may also speak, this is the slope m of tangent is 2x minus 2, right? This is reason number 1. Now, slope of L2, that is slope of second line. So from the figure, this slope of the second line is given by minus a by b formula. Minus a means minus 5 by minus 15. That will be what? 1 upon 3. So, slope of line 2 is 1 by 3, right? This is equation 2. But here, what would say? Tangent is perpendicular to L2 as given. Therefore, the slope of tangent into slope of second line is equal to minus 1. Therefore, 2x minus 2 into 1 by 3 equal to minus 1, right? So this is the obtained from This is number 1 and 2. And just by solving this, you will be able to get some value of x. So 2x minus 2 will be equal to minus 3. So 2x will be equal to minus 1. X will be equal to minus 1. This time, in the second condition, we got x as minus 1 by 2. So now with this help value of x, now the x will be what? For second case, the first case is turned off. So I am eliminating the first case. I am just erasing this. First case is done. Yeah. Now for the second case, the point of the value of x is minus 1 by 2. So it is minus 1 by 2. Now what I require? Y. Okay. As well, I require real value of slope of tangent to frame the equation. That is, I am going to do. Yeah. So first, I will use this value of x to find the slope of tangent from the equation 1. If I substitute the value of x here, I will be able to get slope of tangent. So therefore, the slope of tangent first is given by 2 into minus 1 by 2 minus 2. This is 2 to get cancelled. Minus 1 minus 2, that is minus 3 over. Now the point P, that is minus 1 by 2 comma y, lies on the curve. Lies on the curve. Therefore, it satisfies the curve. So, y is equal to minus 1 by 2 the whole square minus 2 into minus 1 by 2 plus 7. So, y equal to positive 1 by 4 positive 1 plus 7. By simplifying, you will get 8. 8, 4, so 32 plus 1, 33. So this is the value of y I got. Okay. So now, what is the real point? Basically, now I got minus 1 by 2, comma 33 upon 4. I got the real point. Now, I know the slope of the tangent, I know the point of intersection of the tangent to the curve. By using this information, now I can go for equation of tangent. Equation of tangent. So, equation of tangent means simply y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x1. So, y minus y1 is 33 upon 4 equal to, what is the slope I have? Minus 3 into x minus x1 is minus 1 by 2 becomes plus 1 by 2. Now take LCM first and go with the cross multiplication. You will be able to get the equation of tangent, that is the last step. So I hope, friends, I will be able to make you understand the concept how to deal with whether the other informations are given. They are not giving the direct point of intersection to find the equation of tangent or equation of normal. So, but they are giving some more information which you have to use to get that x, y as an intersection point. Now, I would like to take the last question of today's session. Last question which I am going to discuss now. Question number here 11. Question number 11. find the equation or equation of all lines having slope to which are tangents to the curve y equal to 1 upon x minus 3, where x is not equal to 3. What we require here? Find the equation of all lines which having the slope 2, slope is clearly defined, which are tangents to this curve. Again saying, to find the equation of tangent, we require slope and the point at which the tangent is constructed. Slope is clearly given. What we require? Only point of intersection. So we are going to find, again, this is a curve and this is the tangent to the curve. At a point, we don't know what is the point, x1, y1, but we know the slope of this tangent is 2. So one point is very clear, slope is clearly given to you, only you require the point of intersection. Now first, as you know that the by default step derivative of the curve, this is bluntly you can find. So what is the first curve is given as 1 upon x minus 3, where x is not equal to 3. Now the derivative of this function is, you can use a quotient rule or you can also speak the derivative of the any 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Remember, if you are using this formula means you are saving your time. Otherwise, you can go with the u by v rule to get this answer. But if you remember this as a formula, derivative of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Just use that one to get the derivative. So, minus 1 upon x minus 3 the whole square into derivative of this function, that is derivative of this function, because we need to apply the chain rule. So derivative of this is equal to minus 1 upon x minus 3 the whole square into derivative of this function is 1. So therefore, the y dash is equal to minus 1 upon x minus 3 the whole square, which we called it as slope of tangent minus 1 upon x minus 3 the whole square as written. Now, what is the slope of tangent given in the question? Slope of tangent is already given as 2, right? This is the slope of tangent. Hence, we got the slope of tangent in the form of expression. Slope of tangent, real well, slope of tangent is 2. It means that these two must be coincide, right? So, but the slope of tangent, right, to the curve is given as 2. This is the given information. Therefore, I could equate now 2 is equal to minus 1 upon x minus 3 the whole square. Hence, 2 times of x minus 3 whole square, I am expanding this, x square minus 6x plus 9 equal to minus 1. Fine. So this by multiplying, I would be able to get a quadratic equation, minus 12x plus 18 plus 1, that is 9, 0 here. Here we got the derivative. First, let me check. Yeah, minus 1 upon x square derivative, that is slope, and slope of tangent is 2, hence this slope and this slope must be coincide. 2 is equal to minus 1 upon this. Yeah. So x square minus 6x plus 9 equal to minus 1. 2 12s are 18 plus 1, 19. So finally, I got one quadratic equation, 2x square minus 12x plus 19 equal to 0. Now, to get the factors, you need to use the spreading middle term method. Here, 2 19s are 38, 2 19s are 38, hence we require the factors of 38. So, just by doing the factorization, you will be able to get the value of x. Now we require the factors of 38. How we will be getting this roots? 19 to, that is 38, no? 2 19s are, and any other factors is left to find the value of x. Just try yourself, no? To save your time here. So by splitting, you will be able to the two values of x. So with the help of two values of x, you will be able to two values of y, because this point is, again you can say, lies on the given curve. Hence, in the given curve, if you substitute the value of x, whatever you are getting over there, you will be able to get y. In this way, you will be able to get two coordinates of point of intersection. With the help of these point of intersection, by keeping the slope same, you will be able to find the equation of line. That is already we have discussed. When you know the slope, find the point, how to find the equation of a tangent. So I think, so it is, now I am leaving here this portion as a homework to you. You can complete by yourself. So I hope I will be able to make you understand clearly. Please do the practice of this exercise as much as you can, each and every question of the textbook, that is NCERT, including solved example, including miscellaneous exercise. Don't leave a single question from this tangents and normal from NCERT, and no need to move out of this NCERT test book if you are preparing for boards. Okay, so thank you all of you, and be safe, be healthy, right? See you in the next session with the new concept, that is maxima and minima. Thank you all of you.